So we got the news yesterday, not only that the Tigers were in the grand final, but that the Commonwealth Bank, to start with, was dropping that $2 ATM fee, and then the other three big banks...
It did not take long.
..joined in about 2 or 3 minutes later. Do you think this was a coordinated attack, or do you think that it was the Commonwealth Bank legitimately did and the others went, oh, hell, we better jump in there?
I would absolutely love to know. Clearly, I think the Commonwealth Bank has got the worst image problem out of all of them because of sort of events of the last 6 or 12 months.
Yes.
But I wonder how long they've been waiting and whether they all thought CommBank would go first and they're all just ready to go afterwards.
It's a stinky and outrageous fee that apparently puts on about $500 million a year the banks make from it. Martin North, banking analyst with Digital Finance Analytics, is on the line. Hi, Martin.
Morning.
Did we see this coming?
Well, there were some early signs. If you look overseas, this has been happening elsewhere around the world. But I guess the timing here in Australia is quite interesting.
How big a win is it for consumers, and who are the biggest winners?
Well, I think it is a win, and it's you know a long time coming, particularly because most of the fees are actually incurred by people in regional areas where, in fact, there are a small number of ATMs and often somebody else's ATM. So effectively, it was a differential tax on taking money out. And also, of course, in regional areas, cash is perhaps used more than in some of the more suburban and central city areas where, of course, you've got many alternatives. So it's, I think, a win, and it's definitely a win for the region.
It was always a fee that we hated. How much was it actually? Did it cost a bank to be able to process a transaction from another bank? I mean, what was the real cost for them?
Well, it's a good question. You've got to think about it in two parts. One, there's the electronic messaging of sending the withdrawal from one bank to another, and that's just a cent or two. Then you've got to think about stacking up the cash in the machine. That's mostly outsourced, but I guess it would probably, on average, for an ATM withdrawal, be about 35 or 40 cents. So they were always making more than the cost.
And Martin, how big a hit are they going to take anyway? I mean, are we really using ATMs like we used to?
Well, no. There's a really significant change going on, and the total volume of transactions has been falling quite consistently over the past few years. My expectation is that we will see ATMs being used less and less, and that's because you've got mobile payments, you've got pay and go, you've got many different payments, and people, of course, can get cash out from supermarkets and other places too. So effectively, the ATM is yesterday's banking. So in a way, you could say that the ATM is being out-evolved by the mobile phone.
Mami, so the treasurer stand-up, I must say, he and other treasurers in the past hadn't managed to get rid of this fee, but he stood up and said a quick warning to the banks, don't pass this on in any other way. Is there a threat of that they'll pass it on in the form of another fee?
Well, of course, the difficulty is it's very hard to decompose all of the fee flows, the costs and the revenues within an organisation because there's lots of cross-subsidisation that goes on. So there is always the risk that we suddenly find it being sort of stuck on somewhere else. But if you think about the relative value of this in $500 million compared with, for example, a 10 basis point tweak on the mortgage rate, it's such a small relative amount that it will get lost in the roundings.
Martin, good chatting. Thank you very much. Martin North, banking analyst from Digital Finance Analytics. Do you love banks anymore now?
Not particularly. We should mention too, I reckon, based on this, so we've gotten rid of that. It's fair rip-off. We've always known it has been.
Shocker.
It's gone.
Yeah.
7:30. What should be next? What are the other rip-offs that we've got to get rid of next?